Good morning. In the last lecture, we talked about PN junction diode construction, explanation of all the things related with the PN junction diode, circuit diagram, various terms related with diode, the circuit diagram for study of diode in reverse bias and forward bias, and VI characteristics. Next one is Zener diode. Let us go to that one. Zener diode. Zener diode is again a semiconductor diode. It is having the same crystal structure as ordinary PN junction diode. All properties of Zener diode are similar to properties of the PN junction diode. Then why the different name is given to this diode? The reason is PN junction diode is always used in forward bias. It is never used in reverse bias because it gives current, it conducts the electrical current when it is in forward bias. It does not conduct any electrical current whenever it is in reverse bias. And therefore, whenever we use a diode in any electrical circuit, in any electronic circuit, the diode is always used in forward bias. Mostly it is used in forward bias. In very rare cases, it may be used in reverse bias. In almost all cases, in almost all circuits, it is used in forward bias. Zener diode. It is also PN junction diode. Unlike ordinary PN junction diode, Zener diode is used in reverse bias. Zener diode is specially fabricated, specially manufactured to operate in reverse bias. We can use Zener diode in forward bias, but when Zener diode is used in forward bias, it will act just similar to ordinary semiconductor PN junction diode. There is no speciality about the Zener diode whenever it is used in forward bias, because we already have ordinary PN junction diode which can be used in forward bias. We do not need Zener diode for that purpose. But whenever we want to use the diode in reverse bias and it should conduct current in reverse bias, it should operate in reverse bias. Its operation must be safe in reverse bias. In that case, the only alternative is Zener diode. We can use Zener diode whenever we want to use a diode in reverse bias for its proper operation. It will act properly, unlike the ordinary PN junction diode. work properly, it means that it will conduct the current heavily, safely, when it is connected in reverse bias. PN junction diode could not work safely in reverse bias. If it is used in reverse bias and made to conduct the current, it will be damaged permanently. After breakdown, the PN junction diode will be damaged permanently. This is not the case with Zener diode. When we talk of Zener diode works safely in reverse bias. It can provide current, required current and required voltage without any damage to the Zener diode. And therefore, speciality of Zener diode, although it is PN junction diode, is that it can work safely and properly in reverse bias, unlike the PN junction ordinary PN junction semiconductor diode. It means that the certain changes are made in the fabrication or manufacturing of this Zener diode with reference to the construction of ordinary PN junction diode. What changes are made? The changes made for construction of Zener diode is the doping level. What is doping? The process of addition of pentavalent or trivalent impurity to the intrinsic semiconductor to convert it into extrinsic semiconductor is known as doping. The concentration of doping is much more. Doping level is much high in case of Zener diode as compared to ordinary PN junction diode. As doping level is very, very high in Zener diode, the number of holes available in P region, number of electrons available in N region are very, very large in number as compared to ordinary PN junction diode. Because of this high concentration of electrons in N type of semiconductor and holes in P type of semiconductor, the width of depletion region is very, very narrow in Zener diode. The width of depletion region we studied in the ordinary PN junction diode, that depletion region will have very narrow width in Zener diode because the doping level is held very high in case of Zener diode. More number of pentavalent and trivalent impurity atoms are added into Zener diode. The proportion of addition of impurity atoms for ordinary PN junction diode is 1 part in 10 to the power 8 parts. In case of Zener diode, this is not the proportion. The proportion is much more than this proportion. And therefore, its depletion region is very, very narrow. As depletion region of this Zener diode is very narrow, it can work very safely in the breakdown region and can provide us the required voltage and current in the reverse bias. Actually, Zener diode is constructed to work in reverse bias only. It is generally not used in forward bias. Zener diode is specially constructed, specially fabricated to work in reverse bias. And therefore, whenever we use a Zener diode, it is always used in reverse bias. It is never used in forward bias. As I told, Zener diode is nothing but a PN junction semiconductor diode. First thing. Second thing, it can operate just similar to ordinary PN junction diode when connected in forward bias. Second thing. Third thing, Zener diode can operate very safely in reverse bias, unlike ordinary PN junction diode. Fourth thing, whenever Zener diode is working in reverse bias, breakdown of Zener diode occurs. This breakdown is safe breakdown. In this breakdown, there is no damage to the PN junction. There is no damage to the Zener diode. What important thing about Zener diode? Zener diode works in breakdown region whenever it is connected in reverse bias, and it is working safely in a breakdown region. There is no damage to the Zener diode at all whenever it is working in the reverse bias. A large current can flow through the Zener diode whenever it is in reverse bias. Voltage across the Zener diode after breakdown. Voltage across the Zener diode when it starts conducting in reverse bias is almost constant. That voltage is not going to change. And therefore, this Zener diode can work as a constant voltage source. Whenever it is working in reverse bias in the breakdown region, Zener diode may work as a constant voltage source. As Zener diode works as a constant voltage source, whenever it is operating in the breakdown region, Zener diode can be used as a voltage regulator. We can use Zener diode as a voltage regulator. The operation of Zener diode in the breakdown was successfully explained by the American scientist C. Zener. The operation of Zener diode in the breakdown region. Safe operation of Zener diode in the breakdown region is successfully explained, properly explained by the American scientist C. Zener. And in honor of that scientist, name of this diode is Zener diode. The current flowing through the diode in reverse bias is known as Zener current. And the breakdown voltage from which the diode starts conducting heavily in reverse bias, that breakdown voltage is known as Zener breakdown voltage. There are various types of Zener diodes. The types of Zener diodes are described by their Zener breakdown voltage. If a diode is of 5 volt, its breakdown voltage will be 5 volt. If a diode is of 6 volt, it means that its breakdown voltage is 6 volt. If a Zener diode is of 9 volt, it means that its breakdown voltage will be 9 volt. Whatever may be the breakdown voltage of a diode, it will be always constant. The voltage across the Zener diode will be always constant once it starts conducting in the breakdown region. Because of this property, Zener diode is a very special diode since it can work as voltage regulators. The voltage of a general diode is decided by the doping level. If doping level is very, very high, the breakdown voltage of the general diode will be low. It may be 3 volt, 5 volt, like that, depending on the doping level. If you want to have general diodes of higher and higher voltages, the doping level of the general diode is decreased accordingly. Low level of doping corresponding to high breakdown voltage of the general diode. High doping level corresponding to low breakdown voltage of the Zener diode. It is having charge neutrality just similar to the charge neutrality of ordinary PN junction diode. Number of holes, number of free holes in P type is always equal to number of immobile negative ions in the P region. Similarly, number of free electrons in the N region of a Zener diode is always equal to number of immobile positive ions, and therefore Zener diode is neutral in nature. Its P type is neutral in nature. Its N type semiconductor is also neutral in nature. So, whenever we talk of net charge on P-type or N-type of this Zener diode, it is always zero. And therefore, Zener diode is neutral. The whole crystal structure of the Zener diode is neutral, just similar to the crystal neutral crystal structure of ordinary P-N junction diode. Everything will be same. The other thing will be just similar to the ordinary PN junction diode. What difference is in Zener diode? The doping level. The symbol of ordinary PN junction diode is this, as you know. In the last lecture, I gave the symbol for ordinary PN junction diode. This is P-type, this is N-type. This bar and this arrowhead corresponding to N-type. This bar and this arrowhead corresponding to N-type. And this is corresponding to P-type. This is symbol for ordinary PN junction diode. But when symbol for Zener diode is to be used, that will be of this type. This is symbol for Zener diode. The bar over here is replaced by letter Z. This is letter Z corresponding to Zener diode. Okay, so this is the symbol for the Zener diode. Whenever we use Zener diode in any circuit, Zener diode is always represented by this symbol. This sign corresponding to N type of semiconductor of Zener diode. This is corresponding to P type of semiconductor of Zener diode. Whenever we use Zener diode in any circuit, we are supposed to read the manufacturing, the sheet provided by manufacturers of Zener diode. That provides the parameters of the Zener diode, its resistance in forward bias, its resistance in reverse bias, the resistance to opposition of flow of electrical current through the Zener diode when it is in forward bias, when it is in reverse bias. मैक्सिमम करंट हैंडलिंग कैपेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस इनर डायोड. इफ द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू दोज इनर डायोड इज नॉट कंट्रोल्ड, वेरी हेवी करंट मे फ्लो थ्रू द इनर डायोड एंड इट मे बर्न द इनर डायोड. And therefore, whenever we are using Zener diode, it should be used in such a way that maximum current flowing through the Zener diode should be smaller than the burnout current. Burnout current, the current which burns out the Zener diode. These things should be always remembered. So the data sheet of Zener diode should be read carefully. The data sheet also provides the breakdown voltage of Zener diode. That is, Zener breakdown voltage is also mentioned on the data sheet. And therefore, the rating of Zener diode should be read carefully whenever a Zener diode is used in any circuit. Let us see how to use Zener diode in reverse bias and in forward bias. Let me draw these two circuits. After that, we can draw the VI characteristics of the Zener diode. And this is So first figure is corresponding to forward bias of Zener diode. Second figure is corresponding to reverse bias of Zener diode. How the connections are made? This is a power supply. This is variable knob of the power supply. Positive terminal of the power supply, negative terminal of the power supply. Resistance R to control excessive current flowing through the Zener diode. Voltmeter to measure voltage across the Zener diode. Millimeter to measure current flowing through the Zener diode. Okay, current flowing through the Zener diode will be IZ. This current will be IR. This current will be IL. IR. IZ. IL. Now, this is load resistance RL. It also used to control the current flowing through the Zener diode, because current, this IR is current flowing through this resistance R. Okay, when it comes to here, it will get divided into IL and IZ. So excessive current will not flow through the diode, and Zener diode can work safely. P type of Zener diode is connected to positive of the power supply. N type of Zener diode is connected to negative of the power supply. And so it is forward bias of Zener diode. Here, the same thing, only P and N type of the Zener diode is reversed in circuit 2. Here, N type is downward, P type upward. Here, N type is upward, P type is downward. Rest of the connections are same. And N type connected here to positive of the power supply, P type connected to negative of the power supply. Here it is used in reverse bias, here it is used in forward bias. And this R, this RL, these are used to control current flowing through the Zener diode, so that Zener diode can work safely. It may be in forward bias or it may be in reverse bias. It is conducting in reverse bias as well as in forward bias. But Zener diode is specially fabricated, specially manufactured to conduct in reverse bias. So we never use this circuit for Zener diode, because this is forward bias circuit for Zener diode. We generally do not use this circuit anywhere, because Zener diode is never used in forward bias. The circuit used is always this. This is the circuit for reverse bias of the Zener diode, and Zener diode is specially constructed to work in reverse bias. VI characteristics is the graph between voltage and current of the Zener diode. Let us draw the characteristics for Zener diode, where let me draw it here, because I have described this circuit. So let me draw these characteristics here. This is for forward bias, this is for reverse bias. This is reverse voltage VR, this is forward voltage. This voltage is known as VZ, this voltage, which is the breakdown voltage. This current is IZ, the Zener current. What we find here, if we use the zener diode in forward bias, this will be its VI characteristics, forward voltage, forward current. And what we find, it starts operating at very low voltage because of its high level of doping, because of presence of high concentration of electrons and holes in N-type p-type of semiconductors respectively. The depletion region is very narrow. As depletion region is very narrow, the voltage required to conduct the zener diode in forward bias is very, very small, and therefore it starts operating, it starts conducting the current at very low voltage and the current rises rapidly as we try to increase the forward voltage. This is the working just similar to ordinary PN junction diode, and therefore there is no point in using zener diode in forward bias. Let us come to the reverse bias. What we find when we use the zener diode in reverse bias, current flowing through the zener diode is almost zero, very small. As you see here, this current is very, very small till the reverse voltage reaches this value. What is this value? VZ. What is VZ? Breakdown voltage of zener diode. It is known as zener voltage. And what we find, at this voltage, the current is increasing so rapidly that the current line is just parallel to the y-axis. It means that the zener current is rising very rapidly without making any change in the voltage across the zener diode. Once the zener diode starts working in the reverse bias, starts working in the breakdown, zener breakdown, voltage across the diode is fairly constant. It is not changing at all. What changing? Only the current is changing rapidly. Only the current is increasing very rapidly. If this current becomes excess current, it may burn out the zener diode, and therefore we have used load resistance RL as well as series resistance R so that these two can control current flowing through the zener diode when it works in breakdown region. As current is rising very rapidly, very, very rapidly, which can be seen from the current line, the VI characteristics of zener diode in breakdown, which is exactly parallel to y-axis. It means that current is rising very rapidly without increasing any voltage in the breakdown. There is no change in the breakdown voltage, even by a fraction of volt. And therefore, while using zener diode, we have to take the care that excessive current should not flow through the zener diode. The current more than rated current of the zener diode should not be allowed to flow through zener diode when it works in a breakdown region. That should be controlled by using the load resistance or load resistance and the series resistance also, so that it will work safely. The excessive current may not flow through the zener diode when it is working in breakdown, and its working will be safe. One more thing that can be observed from these characteristics is this distance is constant. This distance between this line and this line, everywhere it is constant. What does this mean? It means that value of VZ across the zener diode is always constant once the zener diode starts working in the breakdown. That is, voltage across the zener diode is constant once it starts working in the breakdown region, once it starts working in the zener region. And therefore, because of this property, and therefore because of this very important property of the Zener diode can be used as voltage regulator. It can be used as constant voltage source. This is the specialty of Zener diode, and therefore Zener diode is mostly used in almost all electronic circuits to provide constant voltage. This is about the construction, working principle, the circuit to work the Zener diode in forward bias, in reverse bias, and VI characteristics of the Zener diode. This is everything about the Zener diode. Hope you understood all these things. Thank you.